My guest, Rick Joyner, a proven prophet, has just received the most serious, the most alarming, and the most specific and graphic prophetic dream about the future of America. Next on this edition of It's Supernatural.
Can ancient secrets of the supernatural be rediscovered? Do angels exist? Is there life after death? Are healing miracles real? Can you get supernatural help from another dimension? Has the future been written in advance? Sid Roth has spent 30 years researching the strange world of the supernatural. Join Sid on this edition of It's Supernatural.
Hello, Sid Roth here. Welcome to my world, where it's naturally supernatural. Well, I was calling my friend Rick Joyner on the telephone. He said, Sid, I just have had a dream that has shook me. It's one of the most vivid dreams, significant dreams I've ever had in my life. And as I know, he's had a number of significant dreams. As a matter of fact, Rick, you've had a number of significant words that have come to pass. And the measurement of whether someone can dream a dream that's from God or have a prophetic word that's from God is, does it come to pass?
Yeah.
Tell us a few things that you've seen in the past that have happened.
Well, in 1987, I saw that the countries under, behind the Iron Curtain, the communist bloc, that they would, that liberty was going to break out, freedom was going to come. And of course, you know, a couple of years later, the wall came down. And a part of that same revelation was, as they experienced increasing liberty, we would experience decreasing liberty and the attack on our liberties. I think that's certainly come to pass. And I saw things back there, and this extensive vision I had that lasted over 2.5 days, I saw things that, it was hard for me to believe would ever come to pass. One of the things that's now unfolding, I saw military action along our southern border with Mexico. I saw pitched battles.
And when you saw it, you thought, that could never happen.
You think about 1987, this, no way this is ever going to happen. And we're there now. But that whole vision, I think, was a panorama and has now given me a timeline for some things. But
now the housing crisis that's going on today, who would have thought when, I mean, you couldn't lose money in real estate. Everything was going up, up, up. What did God show you about that?
Well, we started prophesying 2 years before that this was, there was going to be a collapse. There was going to be a shaking that, the bubble was going to burst. We lost a lot of friends when we started speaking that, as you can imagine. But of course, it came true. And Lord, those who heard and got their lives in order profited from that situation. And, you know, I was, for a long time, just about the only one, I think, that was out saying Y2K is not going to be anything.
That was not a popular message at that time. Everyone wanted Y2K to be a collapse. Yep. I mean, they really didn't want it, but they were sure it was going to happen.
It's amazing how many friends we lost over that one. But I had been seeking the Lord. I said, Lord, why are you showing everybody else stuff about Y2K and you're not showing me one thing about it? And he spoke to me one day. He said, I'm not showing you anything because it's not going to be anything.
Churches were having all of these meetings. Actually, I felt the same way as you. And a top pastor from Chicago called and said, I'm having a panel on how to prepare for Y2K. And I, would you want to be on the panel? I said, sure, but you have to understand, I don't think there's going to be a Y2K. And he didn't invite me.
Yeah.
But you were recently at Moravian Falls, and I've been there. And I love that place. And I have to believe the reason Moravian Falls, North Carolina, has such an open heaven is because of the Moravians. Tell me just a little bit about them.
Well, the Moravians were the true father of modern missions. You know, Count Zinzendorf, even when William Carey was called the father of modern missions, he said, no, Zinzendorf was. He was his inspiration. And he was a German count who, at the time, must have been one of the wealthiest people in the world. And, you know, he had such a vision and a heart for the Lord, and he had a revelation of missions. And this is extraordinary the way he received all of this. But They were so touched by the call of the gospel, especially to the poor, and that they, you know, the very first two missionaries they sent out actually sold themselves as slaves to pay their own passage to go to the West Indies to reach the slaves in the West Indies.
Can you imagine selling yourself as a slave for the gospel? It actually sounds more biblical than some of the presentations I see today. Yeah. But they prayed up in the region called Moravian Falls. And I have so many friends that live out in that area, and they keep telling me they see angels. It's a total open heaven there. And that's where you had your dream. Yeah. Tell me about that.
Well, it is a place. It's where we say we come to Charlotte or, you know, Heritage to meet with people, but Moravian Falls is where we meet with God. And I hardly ever go there without some extraordinary revelation or visitation. And I had a dream.
How significant? I want you to tell me, how significant, based on all of your experience over the years, how significant is this dream?
It shook me personally more than any dream, any revelation I have ever had that I remember. It imparted something so deeply to my soul, the reality of this, the absolute emergency that we are in as a nation, and it was about our country. I have never been shaken this hard before, and you know, in the last few years, I've been trying to sound the alarm because it's the main message the Lord's been giving me, but I've never had it any go this deep or to grip me with just how critical things are, like this dream did.
Is it too late for America's survival? You're going to get some amazing insight from this visitation that Rick had through a dream. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
We'll be right back to It's Supernatural.
One new man. The convergence of Jews and Gentiles, the two becoming one new man in Yeshua. When Jews and Christians become one new man in Messiah Jesus, we will experience a move of God such as the world has never seen. If you want to experience an explosive outpouring of God's Spirit, God's love, God's power, then log on to www.sidroth.org to learn more about the one new man.
We now return to It's Supernatural.
Hello, Sid Roth here with Rick Joyner. And Rick said he had a dream from God that he classifies an emergency for the United States. Rick was in Moravian Falls, where there's an open heaven, and he had a visitation. Tell me just briefly about the dream, and more important, what it means.
Well, it was a brief dream, and in this dream, I was in a log cabin. And every room in this log cabin was a part of America. Now, all this has prophetic symbolism, but I was taken to the different geographical parts, as well as different cultures and industries and places in America. And these little fires kept popping up, and the people leading me around would just go over and stomp them out, and then, like, not pay any attention to them, and it started really bothering me about these little fires. And finally, we were going to go outside, and outside was a military base in this dream, but as we were going out, another fire, just a little one, shot up over, and I went to stomp it out. And when I got there and stomped it out, I realized it had burned through the floor and the subfloor. So I just looked down under the house to see the foundation, and things happen in a dream that are not in the natural, but I could see the whole foundation, and the whole thing was on fire. It's just hot, burning coals, and this is where the little fires were popping up from. And I knew
instantly. But if you destroy the foundation, you destroy the whole house.
That's what's on fire, the foundations. And I immediately, you know, a fireman, if you ever saw something like that, you'd run for your life. That's what I felt in the dream. And in the dream, I wanted to go just five steps over to the side and grab my computer, which is where everything I own is in my computer almost. I was going to grab that. And I heard the voice of the Lord in my dream. He said, "You don't have time for that. get your wife and get the fire hose. And I knew what he meant. And I woke up at that time, and I was sweating. I knew this house was about to explode that was America.
So it now, really is an emergency.
It really is an emergency. And usually in dreams and visions, your wife or bride is the church, the bride. And I know she alone has the hose, the fire hose, the water, which represents the Word of God and the truth. The only thing we can do is pour as much water as we can on the foundations.
Well, while the foundation is being destroyed, we don't have anyone speaking a non-compromised message of truth to speak of. I mean, there are exceptions, but to speak of, what we have gone is to more of a seeker sensitive than a, I hate to say it, but it's true, God sensitive message.
Well, we're in desperate need of leaders in our country that are not politicians, but leaders. And there can be a huge difference. And we're in desperate need of those who will speak the truth boldly without compromise. And they're going to be far more concerned about what God thinks and what men think. You know, the fear of man brings a snare. We can't worry about what man is going to. I tell you, the political correctness is killing us. It's being used against us.
Well, for instance, General Jerry Boykin, I've heard him speak at your place. Tell me his credentials briefly.
Well, he's probably one of our greatest warriors over the last 30 years. He was one of the founding members of Delta Force. He commanded Delta Force. He's the guy Noriega surrendered to in Panama. He was over the Delta Force, you know, Panama and at Mogadishu in the battle that was made famous in the Black Hawk Down movie. General Boykin was over that, and he's been...
He's a former Green Beret.
He was Green Beret and then Delta Force, which was Special Operations.
How does he know so much about Marxism and socialism?
Well, Jerry went on to oversee covert operations at CIA for 3 years. He was our Deputy Secretary of Defense for Intelligence after that. And he was trained as a Green Beret. And when he was coming up in these things, the greatest threat to America was socialism. And they were trained to identify and recognize the encroachment or the insurgency of Marxism at the time. And that's when we got Jerry, you know, I got him do this little video.
Oh, I'll tell you what, I want you to see just a small segment of this video. It is, he's not a people pleaser, that you'll find out.
We hear a lot about Marxism and socialism, and there are those, particularly in the media, who would say that we should tone down our rhetoric about socialism because we're not moving to socialism. Well, the reality is, I'm a Special Forces officer. I'm a Green Beret, and I've studied Marxist insurgency. It was part of my training. And the things that I know that have been done in every Marxist insurgency are being done in America today. The first thing that has happened when people like Fidel Castro have moved their societies towards Marxism is they've nationalized major sectors of the economy. Folks, that's what the bailouts were, nationalizing major sectors of the economy. The second thing they've done is they've redistributed wealth. We've heard enough about the redistribution of wealth. And in fact, the man that was appointed to handle Medicaid and Medicare, after he was seated in the office, actually stood up and said publicly that health care was nothing but a redistribution of wealth. The third thing that they do is they discredit their opposition. Now, I've never been so angry with my government as when a Department of Homeland Security memorandum went around to law enforcement all over the country saying that the future threats to America were right-wing Christian groups, pro-life groups, Second Amendment groups, and returning veterans. I'm still angry about that. But it never said Islamic terrorist. That's discrediting the opposition, the very groups that would stand up and protest the things that they see happening in our country. And the final thing that is done in the Marxist model is societies like Cuba, like Venezuela today, like Russia, under Stalin, or China under Mao Zedong. things they have done, the final thing has been actually to develop a constabulary force, a force that can control the population. You say, well, we don't have that. Well, let me remind you that prior to the election, the president stood up and said that if elected, he would have
a civilian national security force that's just as powerful, just as strong, just as well-funded
as the United States military. For what? Remember, Hitler had the brown shirts. And in the Night of the Long Knives, even Hitler got scared of the brown shirts and killed thousands of them. Well, so you say, are there any signs that that's actually happened? The truth is, yes. If you read the health care legislation, which, by the way, no one in Washington has read, but if you read the health care legislation, it's actually in the health care legislation. There are paragraphs in the health care legislation that talk about the commissioning of officers in time of a national crisis to work directly for the president. It's laying the groundwork for a constabulary force that will control the population in America. You need to understand this is happening in America, and it fits the model that societies have that have been used when societies move to Marxism.
We'll be right back to It's Supernatural.
20 years ago, internationally recognized prophetic voice Rick Joyner prophesied and wrote about the coming down of the Iron Curtain. The subprime mortgage crisis would occur and cripple the U.S. economy, and America would have major problems on our border with Mexico. Rick Joyner has just received the most serious, alarming, specific, and graphic prophetic dream about the future of America in 2011, and he wants to share how you can be prepared and survive these coming judgment warnings. Call now and receive Rick Joyner's DVD and CD set, which includes his end time message on audio CD, Preparation for Transfiguration, plus his DVD, Will America Survive 2011? Both yours for a donation of $22. Shipping and handling is included. On this DVD, Rick shares his prophetic dream and the dream of an Orthodox rabbi who believes in Jesus. Both dreams are warnings of the dangers facing America this year, 2011. Plus, on this same DVD, you will hear the full-length version of retired Lieutenant General Jerry Boyd warning on Marxist communism in America. And through Rick's end time message on audio CD, you will clearly understand how to escape the coming judgments. Rick also prays with you for an impartation to help spark revival in your life, your community, and your nation. Don't miss out on getting proven prophet Rick Joyner's end time message on audio CD, Preparation for Transfiguration, plus his eye-opening message on DVD, Will America Survive 2011? Both yours for a donation of $22. Shipping and handling is included. Ask for offer number 1352. Call, write to the address on your screen, or log on to sidroth.org. Call or write today.
We now return to It's Supernatural.
Hi, Sid Roth here with Rick Joyner, and a pretty sobering program. Rick, there's some serious things going on in the United States of America. From your dream, you saw the foundation all over being attacked. But then you got a call from a friend of yours that's an Orthodox Jewish rabbi that had a dream that was confirmation to you. Explain.
Yeah, it was quite a startling dream. He had it on the evening of October 29th, and he saw in this a huge bear. And, you know, to cut right to the chase, it was a bear market that exceeded the 1929. In his dream, it was much larger than the bear that was in 1929, which he also saw in this dream.
Well, 29 was a pretty bad bear market, but yeah. This is going to be worse, is what he saw?
That's what he saw. Now, both of these dreams, mine too, with the entire foundation, I don't think the Lord would have said, get your wife, get the hose, if we could not put that fire out, if we couldn't stop this from happening. And I think the same with him. He was shown in this dream a gun that was used to kill the 1929 bear, which was basically the Lord's kingdom is coming, to have that faith, to have that peace, and seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Those scriptures were, they were burned into that gun. They were engraved into it. And the gun that shot the first bear. Well, he said, you in this dream, he was told, you can kill this bigger bear with the same gun. We have to seek God's kingdom above everything else. That is the only answer.
So you know the credentials of Rick Joyner. I'm just finding out about this Orthodox Jewish rabbi that believes in Jesus. He lives by faith. What did he tell you about money materializing?
Yeah, he went through a period of time where he would open his Bible, and of course he reads the Hebrew Bible and he reads the Greek.
Of course.
And he, every time there was money in it. Now, there was not possible for anyone to slip in, put money in them in this situation. And he kept emailing me and saying, this is incredible. Money is appearing in my Bibles. And this went on for a long period of time. And I think it was a sign. But, you know, Lord did that. He told Peter, go get this fish and you'll find the money in the fish.
Okay. You know, how have these two dreams changed your life, Rick Joyner?
Well, they were so sobering. I mean, what I saw in my own dream is like planting. It was so real. I remember it like a real experience, not like a dream. And it's just branded on me. And I feel that God has, you know, shown me that the foundation that he put in our country, he's had me on a search of that in the last few years to really see his handiwork in his hand. And he's just planted something, and we can't lose this country. He really has a destiny that we have not yet fulfilled in this country. But we will lose it if the church does not wake up and does not speak the truth with clarity, with boldness, without compromise.
Okay, Rick, a lot of people are enthusiastic that there's going to be some solutions for this country in the political arena. What do you think?
Well, I thank God that Christians are waking up and becoming the salt and light we're called to be. When he said go into all the world, it wasn't just geographical. We're supposed to be getting, Christians should be going into government, business, and, you know, entertainment, the arts, everything as missionaries. And I think this is happening. So I am very thankful about Christians awakening and getting engaged and involved. But I think many of the ultimate issues are already beyond human remedy. We've got to have God to make it through what's coming. We've got to seek first the kingdom. Now, that doesn't mean we're not engaged in politics, and that doesn't have some of the answers, but we need wisdom from above. We need Joseph's and Daniel's prophetic voices in the ear of our political leaders, our government leaders, and everything else, or we really aren't going to make it through the times.
Now, tell me a bit about Islam and the Islamization of Paris, of England, which to me is kind of like a preview of what's going to happen in the United States.
Well, it is remarkable.
Unless
we wake up.
Correct.
One thing, you know, we're supposed to understand the times. Lord called them hypocrites who did not understand the signs of the times or who understood the weather better. We are supposed to understand. You cannot understand the modern world without understanding Islam. And yet we've been made to think you can understand it, don't touch it, you know, that's Islamophobia, whatever. But the whole country's waking up to, no, we have to understand this issue. It's not just a religion. It is a totalitarian form of government called Sharia law that they're seeking to impose on every nation on the earth. That is what jihad is about. It's not just getting people to convert to Islam. They just assume you didn't convert because they, you know, according to that doctrine and in their book, you either become a convert to Islam or you become a slave or they have the right to kill you. So they would just assume have plenty of slaves. But we really need to understand what this religion is all about. It's not just a religion. It's using religion for domineering. And also, I think in the same spirit of seeking to wipe out the Jewish people, that we have to realize that they are operating the same spirit that rose up in the 30s and 40s in Europe. And this is happening all over the world.
Okay. We see what's happening in Islam. We see what's happening in the United States of America. We see the foundation of the whole United States is shaking and about ready to collapse. Is there real hope in your opinion? Real hope?
Absolutely. Absolutely. All these things, God is not sitting in heaven wringing his hand over any of this. Now, he says the heavens of the Lord, the earth he's given into the hands of the sons of men. So, you know, the Holy Spirit is the helper, not the doer. He expects us to get engaged, but he will help us. He can change all of this, turn all of this into a great victory for the truth, a great victory for his people and his kingdom and everything else. But we have to get engaged. He won't do things on the earth until we pray. He said, the heavens are mine, but I gave you the earth. I'll help you, but you've got to ask me.
Yeah, you know what I believe? I believe we're about ready to have, Rick, the greatest revival the world has ever seen. And I believe that the United States of America's days are not finished. But the balance, as Rick is saying, is up to the sleeping giant. Will the sleeping giant lay down their differences? Will the sleeping giant put God's kingdom first as opposed to their kingdom? Do you know something? Jesus didn't start with a whole lot of people. He started just with a dozen men and women that know God. Rick, I believe, could change this earth. I believe we're about ready to have a tsunami, a major tsunami of God's Spirit, and you can be a part of it as long as Jesus is your Lord. If not, do something right now. You know what to do.
20 years ago, internationally recognized prophetic voice Rick Joyner prophesied and wrote about the coming down of the Iron Curtain. The subprime mortgage crisis would occur and cripple the U.S. economy, and America would have major problems on our border with Mexico. Rick Joyner has just received the most serious, alarming, specific, and graphic prophetic dream about the future of America in 2011, and he wants to share how you can be prepared and survive these coming judgment warnings. Call now and receive Rick Joyner's DVD and CD set, which includes his end time message on audio CD, Preparation for Transfiguration, plus his DVD, Will America Survive 2011? Both yours for a donation of $22. Shipping and handling is included. On this DVD, Rick shares his prophetic dream and the dream of an Orthodox rabbi who believes in Jesus. Both dreams are warnings of the dangers facing America this year, 2011. Plus, on this same DVD, you will hear the full-length version of retired Lieutenant General Jerry Boyd warning on Marxist communism in America. And through Rick's end time message on audio CD, you will clearly understand how to escape the coming judgments. Rick also prays with you for an impartation to help spark revival in your life, your community, and your nation. Don't miss out on getting proven prophet Rick Joyner's end time message on audio CD, Preparation for Transfiguration, plus his eye-opening message on DVD, Will America Survive 2011? Both yours for a donation of $22. Shipping and handling is included. Ask for offer number 1352. Call, write to the address on your screen, or log on to sidroth.org. Call or write today.
Next week on It's Supernatural. Instant weight loss. Bald heads grow hair, and gray hair turns back to its original color. I have seen this happen with my very own eyes.